Today, we're going to install this Renogy 2000 watt inverter in our 2021 four-wheel camper Hawk pop-up. We're not getting sponsored by this company in any way or form. It's just I did a lot of research and I had good reviews and it fits our needs. It comes with a remote and a connection cable for that, as also these two connection wires for your battery. They're rather short. They're not going to work for us, so we're not going to use them. Instead, I picked up at Napa some jumper wire cable from the same gauge diameter. It's cheap. You can buy it at Napa, Walmart, whatever fits your needs. And also this 250 amp fuse block for safety. If you got a short, at least we're protected and the camper doesn't burn down. And we're going to install two of these USB outlets. The camper only comes with two. And we just need some extras. So we already did some prep work to install the inverter just to see where we have room, because its room is limited in this camper. Here we're gonna install the remote. There was already a hole. So we're gonna cut this out. This is the outline. And then it's gonna be a flush mount again, same as the solar controller. The USB chargers are gonna be here and here. I wanted to say, check behind this panel because there's running a lot of wires. So if you start cutting, drilling, whatever, make sure there is room behind it. The inverter comes in this cabinet where we normally have our cookery and our plates. So you can see already I got marked where I want the screws to install the inverter. You see the water pump here. I moved it about this way, about an inch and a half, about 3-4 centimeters. Just so I can run the wires behind this line. And otherwise the steel water line was hitting those wires and you never know, it's gonna rub through and create the short. So we're gonna cut some holes and go from there. So let's see if it fits. We did our job right. I think so. Fits like a glove. Next step, I'm gonna install these lugs to the wiring. I already took the insulation off. And then you just put them in, slide them in. I crimp them in place with these big water pump pliers. And most people say tight is tight enough, but what I like to do for a superb connection and so they won't come loose, I'm gonna fill them up with solder. So I'm gonna use this little torch, warm up the lug, and I'm just gonna fill it up with solder. It's a time-consuming process, but if you want to do it right, it never comes loose. You just wait till the solder heat it up and then the solder starts flowing to where your flame is. So if it's right here on the bottom, see, just going in, and it will fill up the lugs. It is a timely process. It will take a little bit and it's gonna get really hot. So when you're done, you really have to let it sit for a while before you can actually touch it again and install it. Done. The solder I'm using is a mixture of 60-40 silver and tin. Okay, for the USB chargers, I'm gonna steal power here from behind this board. It has a 12 volt cigarette lighter plug that we never use, so I'm gonna use the power for that. Switches on and off. So I want to make sure my cable is long enough. Stick it through there. Like that. Same for the other one. Got some extra. Should be lots. I solder everything with heat shrink.
because I think it's the best connection. These are insulated heat shrink, so there's some glue in there. When you warm it up, they shrink and the glue runs out and makes it a watertight connection, especially in the camper. I think that's important. Then we have the remote control for energy. You take the surrounding off, plug in the cable, so it's ready. Drop in that cable through the hole. And I'll stick this in place. Screw all this tight off camera. And then when this is done, we're gonna route the wiring in place, put the inverter in place. So the wires are cooled off. I put some electrical tape around the lugs. They're nice and tight, so you don't get any shorts. The positive thing about this Renogy inverter has these plastic clips that go around it for extra protection. And the bolts that you secure the wires to the inverter have an extra locking nut. So you tie them up from the top. Like that. Then you put the nut underneath. Take a half inch ratchet wrench. And you just torque them. That's what they call secure connection. And of course, red is positive, black is negative. I guess didn't do that very well, like that. Why am I doing this now and not in the camper? Because the space is so tight. I'm gonna put the wires on here and then work my way through the camper and bring them to the battery. There's just not enough room to do it over there. We got the inverter installed against the back wall here. You can see the power is connected. The remote control is connected. I wired the wiring and tied it up to the original loom. Here in the corner on the far right, there is a hole that goes underneath the cabinets. And then we run it behind the inverter to the batteries. Here you can see the battery cables that are hooked up to the inverter exiting the hole behind the converter where we routed them. They come to this 250 amp fuse block. Power from the battery that's hooked up right here and the ground on this side. There's two batteries. Let's turn it on. Here you see the final result. The remote for the inverter. So we can switch that on. Turns on green, so that's a good sign. I'll plug in this adapter. It's red. Turn it off. It goes off. As you can see, I utilized the original socket here that was in the camper already. We don't use a lot of 110. We actually never hook up to shore power anyway. The original wiring is still there. It's insulated and tucked away, so nothing can happen. But I didn't want to drill more holes in the camper than needed. So this is what we're going to use for now. And maybe we're going to switch box installed later. The master switch for this panel. It also feeds our two USB chargers that are installed. You can switch them on and switch them off if you don't need them. That one goes off, and that's it, the final end result.